Hello students, today we will learn to connect Java with database. Let us learn JDBC with MS Access connection. For that, let us first design one database. Let the name of the database is DB and the table name is student. Four titles are there: ID, name, roll number and address. After designing the database, one more thing is required: download UCANACCESS and place that content in JDK folder, UCANACCESS driver. You can download easily because JDBC ODBC bridge is deleted in Java 8 version. That's why UCANACCESS is required. You can download from here. You can access 5.0.0. After downloading, let us open the zip file. I have already downloaded, but my version is 4.0.4. You can download 5.0. Here one file is there, you can access, and inside the library four files are there. You have to copy these four files along with you can access. Now open C drive, program files, Java, JDK 1.8, JRE, library and ext. This path is required. You can note down this path. Inside C, program files, Java, JDK 1.8, JRE and library and ext. You have to paste all the five files here. These all should be jar files. You can access is here along with four other files. These two contents are important. One is designing of your database, and second one is downloading UCANACCESS files. One file is UCANACCESS and four other files. You have to copy and paste the content inside the specific folder set by me. Now about Java database connectivity with MSSS. First of all, designing of a database. We have already designed the database. Inside E drive, you can design according to your choice, but you have to give the path accordingly. What was there before Java 8? Suppose one string is there. I have declared one string named as database, and name of the file is db.accdb inside the folder db in E drive. Then the connection is there, JDBC ODBC bridge driver. Basically, before Java 8, this type of code was there. And then bridge for bridge designed using this class name. And in Java 8, we can do connectivity with the help of UCANACCESS. String name, obviously, it will remain as it is, database. Code is so small, JDBC. UCANACCESS, then name of the database. Class.forName, net.ucanacess.jdbc, UCANACCESS driver. It's also simpler to previous one. How to use UCANACCESS, I have already explained after downloading the content. Inside a JDK folder, you have to place 5 files regarding UCANACCESS. Now the main points taken into consideration while developing a program for database connectivity. Basically some bullets are there, some basic points are there so that you can design the program easily. Some bullets are there, DC SSSRD. DC SSSRD. What is the meaning of D? D stands for driver, C for connection, and S, first S for statement, and second for string, then SQL query, then result set, and last is display. These contents are required. Now inside the program, the first content required is class name, connection, then statement, string, then result set, then with the help of loop we can display all the contents or all the rows of a particular column. Basically rs.getString2 represent the column name. Now let us execute the program using NetBeans. This content is there, I explained to you inside the program. We have to place all the contents inside try-catch block, class.forName, then connection, JDBC, UCANACCESS, then path is there, then statement, string, result set is there, and suppose I am writing 3 here, it means I can display the third column. Let us execute the program. Yes, third column is there. Suppose we have to display all the columns simultaneously. Then what we have to do? Let us write the code. New line. Then first column. Then with the help of tab, with the help of tab, you can display the second column, rs.getString2. Let us display the content. So first and second column is there. Similarly, if I copy the content, Control C, and change the value to 3. Again execute the program. You can see the complete table, all the contents according to your choice. These are the contents, first column, second and third column. First column comprise of ID, second is name, third may be roll number, and according to your choice you can display the content. Hope you understand the concept of JDBC along with the MS-ACCESS connectivity using UCANACCESS. For any query you can comment in the comment section of the video. Thank you.